off, the timer will stop. They're not allowed to crush their can. They can't shop on it. It's just straight up chugging their bottle. Now you guys are gonna have to, help out by cheering them on, okay? We do this chant. The person with the lowest time is the winner, and
Well, except for here. All the meat spreads. Oh, see, there's someone just in the other guy playing the game. Not quite as many people playing Overwatch this year. Not as much. Quaking, so a few people are still playing Quake. The Batman one? Shadow of Batman.
Thank you. to the very end of 2C just being on the ball, their defense has been impeccable, and then finally been able to seize the soul away from No Too Fast. It's been very hard to crack into them. And to remind everybody, you know, Duel and Sacrifice, they're two game modes that have been massive in the World Championship, and many of these players qualified in both game modes. No Faz, Noctis, Toxic, they all made it through in the Duel Cup. And on the flip side, we have Claws on 2Z, who lies in wait in the grand finals of Duel. I mean, if you win Sacrifice and Duel,
talk about QuakeCon.
Yeah, unfortunately, I can't really expand so much about QuakeCon because of not being able to do the entire four-day event, unfortunately. Yeah. With the move to Grapevine to the Gaylord Texan, they have it all in the convention center part, and everything is contained together except for Tabletop Village, and I think some panels were also upstairs on the second or third floor. They had everything contained together, like the BYOC was to the left room when you walk in, and then you had the stage. It was professional shit compared to what it was last year. They were streaming this out, and so like even the camera recording it had graphics like it was recording a movie. By the time I had gotten there, they were doing Sacrifice in Duel. Duel, I think, was the single player 101, and I think Sacrifice was the team play. Instead of it being at night, they had moved it up during the daytime. Bethesda was doing their own thing like they did last year, where you go around and you have to play certain games and get through certain stages in order for you to get your card punch, and so you can get entered into a drawing. $5,000 or $10,000, I think. Unfortunately, they have given everybody at least an hour to play, but by the time I was able to sit down, you either had 20 minutes or until you died. And I only got to play Dishonored 2, which was pretty good. It's been a while since I played number one. It took me 5 minutes to figure out everything, and then like that was 15 minutes done. But by the time I had died, I had to immediately get off. But I think my minutes were up anyway. They didn't do or have PC perceptives like they had last year, which was last year they were drawing numbers, and so your number was drawn, you get to win certain prizes. But it seems like each vendor was doing their own thing. Like AMD was handing out their own things, which I think was just probably like a better thing, so you can be a little bit more interactive with the vendors themselves, especially for those who actually do take the time to build the computers. So I guess it's just a little bit more fulfilling for the vendors to be more interactive with the people who use their hardware. They also have indie showcases, too. Even though everything was contained in an entire room, it still wasn't overcrowded. It still flowed very well, and I could still hear people. Originally, like, the Master Pancake Theater was on Friday. It was going to be Saturday after the championships were done, but they were lacking space, and so you had to have tickets before to watch it. You didn't have that last year.
Oh. Unfortunately, I couldn't make it. I had other issues that were preventing me, and it was just a bad time of year just because school starting and other issues coming up. So, yeah, I'm ready for next year, and hopefully it'll be back at its normal weekend, and yeah. All will be right
and
with the world.
In order for you really to get the immersiveness that is QuakeCon, I think it's better just to go on all days. As many days as you can, especially if you want to take advantage of getting cool stuff when there's hardly enough people there. There's a lot of advantage of you coming earlier if you can, especially during the work days. But definitely, I will recommend it. I have a video. We'll put that up after this episode.
Oh, cool. So.